A very good morning, dear students. Today I'm going to start off with the term turgidity. Most of the students have asked me, what does this term actually mean? So as you can see, I have a balloon in my hand on which I'm assuming that this balloon is a cell, and I have made different cell organelles on this balloon. It is fully swollen, you can say. It is full of water and its plastic or this rubber is totally stretched. So this is the structure of actually a cell. When the cell is fully stretched or fully swollen, it is called turgid, right? So as I told you that plants have a cell wall. Now the cell wall helps the cell to maintain its turgidity because it is the hard covering. Now I have kept this balloon full of water in a glass bowl, and you can see that this glass bowl acts as a cell wall, and this rubber covering of the balloon is working as a plasma membrane. So when the plasma membrane is coated with the cell wall, that means the cell wall will protect this plasma membrane from the outside or environmental harsh conditions. That is why the cell wall is very important in plants. As you already know that why do the plant cells have a cell wall? Because the plants are mostly exposed to the outside or the environmental harsh conditions. They have to bear the weather conditions like storms are there, extreme hot sun is there, or even the rainy season is there, extremely cold winters are there. So the plants, they have to bear all kinds of weathers and conditions. That is why the cell wall protects their cells from these harsh conditions. And turgidity means the cell has to be kept fully swollen or fully blown like this balloon, right? Now what will happen if this plasma membrane ruptures? I'm going to show you here. If I start taking out the water, see, if I slowly take out the water, what's going to happen to the cell organelle? The plasma membrane is shrinking. This condition actually happens when the cell is kept in a hypertonic solution. The plasma membrane, it shrinks because the water content of the cell gets released. Water gets released and the cell shrinks in size. And as you can see, that most of the water content of the cell is lost while keeping it in hypertonic solution, and all the organelles, they have lost their original place. Now these organelles won't be able to perform their functions smoothly because there is not appropriate distance between them and they have like overlapped each other. So this is condition when the cell loses its water and shrinks itself from the cell wall. This is called plasmolysis. आप देख सकते हैं कि सेल जो है वो पहले बिल्कुल सेल वॉल के साथ प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन के साथ अटैच था, बट जब उसकी प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन श्रिंक कर जाती है, देन द सेल एंड अलोंग विद प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन कम्स टू वन कॉर्नर. इट श्रिंक्स अवे फ्रॉम द सेल वॉल एंड दिस कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड प्लाज्मोलाइसिस. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज सेल डिविजन. We have already discussed previously that nucleus is the central point, or it plays a very important role in cell division. So first of all, let me recap your previous class topic. You already have learned that human beings have 23 pairs of chromosomes, right? 22 pairs of chromosomes we call as autosomes. Like they determine the features or the characteristics apart from the sex of the human being. And the last one, that is the one pair of chromosome, is called sex chromosome. Right? So cells having this full number of chromosomes, that means 23 pairs or 46 chromosomes. The cells that are having 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs of chromosomes are called diploid cells. Right? And the cells having unpaired chromosomes or half the number of chromosomes, like if they are having 46 chromosomes, the haploid cell will be having 23 chromosomes only. So cells having unpaired chromosomes or half the number of chromosomes than the actual are called haploid cells. In case of human beings, this is 23 chromosomes. That means not 23 pairs, but just 23 chromosomes. Now there are two methods of cell division. Why this is important? Why? What is the importance of diploid and haploid condition of cells? This is based basically on cell division. Cell division is of two types. First is mitosis, and second is meiosis. Meiosis is also called reduction division. Mitosis kind of cell division occurs in unicellular organisms and the somatic cells. Now, what are somatic cells? I'll explain. Mitosis occurs in somatic cells and unicellular organisms. Now, somatic cells are all the body cells, for example, in skin, hair, muscles, nails, taste buds, stomach's protective lining. The cells that are mainly involved in growth, repair, and replacement of the older cells. And meiosis, that is a reduction division, it occurs in sex cells, that is gametes, and sex cells are also called germ cells. And it leads to the formation of sperms and ova. Okay, now proceeding further. As I mentioned that mitosis happens in all the body cells which are involved in growth and the replacement of the older cells. But exceptions are always there. In case of brain and nerve cells, these cells stop producing after we are a few months old. इन सेल्स की जो ग्रोथ है वो हमारे पैदा होने के कुछ मंथ्स बाद ही रुक जाती है. मीन्स द नंबर ऑफ ब्रेन सेल्स और नर्व सेल्स दैट हैव बीन फॉर्म्ड ड्यूरिंग दैट एज विल रिमेन सेम टिल आर लास्ट ब्रेथ. ओके, हमारे मरने तक जो नर्व सेल्स बन चुके हैं हमारी बॉडी में फॉर द लाइक आफ्टर वी आर बॉर्न एंड आफ्टर अ फ्यू मंथ्स, जितने हम थोड़े मंथ्स के बाद जितने हम बड़े होते हैं उतने टाइम टाइम तक जितने नर्व सेल्स बन गए थे हमारी बॉडी में दे विल रिमेन द सेम टिल आर लास्ट ब्रेथ. They will not increase in number. That means these cells, they stop their reproduction through mitosis also. And liver cells also. Liver cells stop reproducing after we finish our growth. But if there is any injury, liver cells can regenerate its cells. Agar suppose kisi condition se, kisi injury ki vajah se, ya kisi disease ki vajah se, humare liver cells jo hain damage ho gaye hain. To agar 50% of liver is damaged, still the 50% liver can be regenerated by using the reproduction or by using mitosis of these 50% cells. Okay, now I'll briefly explain you what are these processes actually. Mitotic process of reproduction or cell division and meiotic process of cell division. First of all, what happens? Suppose it's a parent cell. In mitotic division, parent cell ke paas jo agar do chromosomes hain, like we can say that this is the diploid parent cell क्योंकि हमारे पास जो भी हमारे body में cells हैं वो complete set of cells हमने inherit किया है from the parents. तो हमारे पास obviously 46 chromosomes हैं, या we can say every cell is having 23 pairs of chromosomes. तो this is the parent cell जिसके पास पूरा अपना diploid set of chromosomes है. जब ये divide करने वाला होगा तो first of all क्या होगा, इसके chromosomes जो they will make a duplicate copy of the chromosomes. I have seen red from the father and blue from the mother. तो every parent cell, उनके जो parents होंगे उन्होंने एक जो है अपने father से लिया है chromosome and एक जो है उन्होंने अपने mother से लिया है, right? So red represents father and blue represents mother over here. So first step towards mitotic division is duplication of these chromosomes. So you can see over here in this diagram, red वाले ने भी duplicate बनाया and blue वाले ने भी अपना duplicate तैयार किया. Right, then these duplicates, first they were attached to each other, then they got separated. After separation, जो हमारा duplicate बना था, one of father and one of mother goes in one daughter cell, and the other of father and other of daughter mother goes in the other daughter cell. So at the end of mitotic division, we get two daughter cells, and each daughter cell is having again diploid number of chromosomes. That means the same number of chromosomes is maintained in both the daughter cells, right? Now let's discuss the meiotic process. What happens in meiotic process? Again, the first step is same. The parent cell is having diploid number of chromosomes. Diploid number of chromosomes gets duplicated in the first step. Duplicated chromosomes then get separated. And then they make two daughter cells. One from father, one from mother in one daughter cell. The other from father, the other from mother goes to the other daughter cell. Now there is another step of division. Again, these two daughter cells which were formed after the mitotic division, they will divide again, and that division will be meiotic division or reduction division. So इसमें क्या होगा कि अब जो अलग अलग chromosome से father and mother का, it will be separated again. So every daughter cell will be having a haploid number of chromosomes. मतलब उनके जो chromosomes हैं वो half हो जाएंगे as compared to the parent. पेरेंट के पास टू नंबर्स था, लेकिन हर यहाँ पे फोर डॉटर सेल्स बनेंगे एंड फोर डॉटर सेल्स के पास सिंगल सिंगल सेट ऑफ क्रोमोसोम होगा, नॉट द पेयर्स ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स. सो दिस इज द हैप्लॉयड नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स इन फोर डॉटर सेल्स एट द एंड ऑफ द मियोटिक डिवीजन. नाउ व्हाई दिस इज हैपनिंग, व्हाई सम सेल्स आर फॉलोइंग दिस माइटोटिक डिवीजन एंड व्हाई सम सेल्स आर फॉलोइंग दिस मियोटिक डिवीजन, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज टू मेंटेन द क्रोमोसोम नंबर एट द एंड ऑफ द रिप्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट मियोटिक डिवीजन शुड टेक प्लेस इन द सेक्स सेल्स. एज आई सेड कि जब हमने रिप्रोडक्शन चैप्टर पढ़ा था अपने क्लास एट में, तो वॉट वी लर्न इन दैट दैट ड्यूरिंग द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ जाइगोट, ओके, द स्पर्म कम्स फ्रॉम फादर एंड द ओवम कम्स फ्रॉम द मदर. सो दे कैरी हाफ ऑफ नंबर्स ऑफ द क्रोमोसोम्स, वो अपना अपना हाफ ऑफ नंबर लेके आएंगे. सपोज दिस इज द स्पर्म सेल एंड दिस इज द डॉटर सेल और ओवम सेल, ओके, दिस इज ओवम, दिस इज स्पर्म. सो अगर एक स्पर्म आ रहा है और एक ओवम आ रहा है, वेन दे फ्यूज टूगेदर देन द जाइगोट विल हैव अगेन अ डिप्लॉयड नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स एंड देन जाइगोट विल अंडरगो रिपीटेटिव डिवीजन्स, मल्टीपल डिवीजन्स टू फॉर्म द एम्ब्रियो एंड फाइनली द फीटस एंड द न्यूली बॉर्न चाइल्ड, ओके. सो दिस मियोटिक डिवीजन, दैट इज वाई इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द सेक्स सेल्स और द गैमीट्स और द जर्म सेल्स टू मेंटेन द सेम नंबर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स by the end of the reproduction process in the daughter cells. So let's briefly discuss the difference between the mitosis and meiotic processes. First of all, difference is like type of reproduction. What type of reproduction is in mitosis? It is asexual reproduction because it takes place in somatic cells and in unicellular organisms where the other sex is not involved or the sex organs or sex cells are not involved. But meiosis is a sexual type of reproduction. Now, daughter cells in number, there are two daughter cells which are formed by the end of mitotic process and there are four haploid daughter cells formed at the end of meiotic cell division. Daughter cells are genetically similar in mitosis because there was no change, there was no fusion of gametes, there was no formation of zygote. That is why the same number of chromosomes were inherited by the daughter from the parent. So daughter cells genetically are similar in mitosis, but they are different in meiosis. Number of divisions, as I mentioned in the diagram, only one division is there in mitosis, but there are two divisions. After formation of two daughter cells, again the two daughter cells will undergo division and they will form four haploid daughter cells by the end. Then mother cells can be haploid or diploid. In case of unicellular organisms, it can be haploid. In case of multicellular organisms, it is diploid. But in meiosis, always diploid number of chromosomes is there in the mother cells. Chromosome number remains same, but in meiosis, it is reduced by half. Okay, then takes place in mitosis takes place in somatic cells, whereas meiosis takes place in gametes, so the germ cells. Then what does it create? Mitosis creates everything except sex cells. Sex cells ke ilawa jitne bhi cells hai hamari body ke, they will be formed by the process of mitosis. Or meiosis mein kya hai? Only sex cells will be formed. Okay? Then what is the function of mitosis? Function kya hai mitosis ka? Ki cellular reproduction, sirf cells ko number mein badhana hai, so that general growth takes place, repair takes place, healing of the body parts takes place. But function of meiosis is that sexual reproduction should be carried on smoothly, genetic diversity should be introduced in the species. Genetic diversity ka matlab hai ki agar suppose every time in the family there is a new member being added, father agar same family chalti aa rahi hai to father agar wahan pe same aa raha hai to mother will be from the other family. Then again if they have a son, then the son will get married to daughter of some other family, then again the genes of the other family will be fused with the genes of their family. So that means genetic diversity is created by meiosis. And maintenance of chromosome number. Chromosome number by the end of the reproduction process should remain same. Okay, so these are the basic differences in mitosis and meiosis. You must learn by heart. With this, we conclude our chapter and I'll be giving you assignment in my next class. Thank you and have a nice day.